This weekend we're gonna do a new song. It's called Let the Nations Be Glad. And I was trying to kind of dive into it a little bit before I let you listen to this song to see, you know, why should, it says at one point in this particular song, let the nations be glad, let the peoples rejoice. Thinking, well, what is to rejoice? And the definition of rejoice is to feel or show great joy or delight. And Paul says it in Philippians over and over and over again that we should rejoice. And so I started doing a little research and I came across a little essay by John Piper. And John Piper says this: how do you rejoice in the Lord if you don't know anything about the Lord? And how do you rejoice in the Lord if you're not seeing things about the Lord that cause joy to rise up in your heart? That is the work of the Holy Spirit. And he doesn't just flip a switch and you rejoice with no mental content whatsoever. The Holy Spirit is given to glorify Jesus Christ, which means the Holy Spirit opens the eyes of my heart to see the beauty of Christ. So as you listen to this song, I want you to think about the fact that it's the Holy Spirit that is working in our hearts to cause joy to rise up from our souls because we see the beauty and the work of Jesus. And we don't just see the beauty and the work of Jesus in the Word, but we see the beauty and the work of Jesus in the world. And so that causes the nations to be glad and the people to rejoice. So I hope that you will listen to this song and be prepared to sing it with us on Sunday. I can hardly wait to rejoice with all the peoples this Sunday.
Be the theme of our song. For by grace we have been saved, and by grace we shall proclaim to the corners of the earth that Christ is come. Now we pray your kingdom come, and we pray.